Hi, Dawn here. I wanted to share with you today some really cool tricks that you can use in PowerPoint. I did this recently and everybody was blown away by how I did these section breaks. I think you'll be excited about it too. It'll make your PowerPoint a lot sharper and easy to navigate. Okay, so I'm sharing screen. You can see my PowerPoint here. And basically I've set it up. I've got different topics, topic one, two, and topic three, and some other fun stuff. So what I'm going to do is start by creating some section breaks, and this is just going to divide up the PowerPoint into easily recognizable portions. So kind of like making chapters, and I can do it manually. I'm going to click between the two slides. I'm over here on the left edge. I'm going to click between those two and I'm going to say, hey, add me a section. And I'll call it topic one. Okay, so that's how I would get started with it. It has an automated feature too. So rather than manually go through and do all those, let me show you a trick. So we are headed to the Insert tab and down to the Zoom section. We're gonna make a summary Zoom out of all our topic areas. So when I go to this, it's recognized I have a section there. I'm gonna give it also topic two and topic three and insert. Look what it's made me. It has made me a summary slide and picked up my three topic slides, my three sections, because see it added topic two section break, topic three section break. So it's got those all in here. Now let me run my show and you'll see what I mean. So when I am in presenting mode and I jump to that next slide, it's in my progression, right? Look at how cool this is. I can jump to topic one and it zooms me into it. I can run through topic one, talk. And as I am finishing that section, it takes me back to the summary section slides, and then I can jump to my next section. How do you like that? Pretty cool, huh? So as I go through the show, again, I finish a section and then here it is going to take me on to that summary slide again as I finish a section. Okay, so that's part one of this little experiment. You should know some fun things though. When you are clicked on this summary slide and you actually click on one of these, you can go to Zoom. It's giving you a new tab. And you can edit how this is laid out. So you can get back in and choose what you want or don't want in your section, your summary Zoom page. So I could take one out if I wanted to and update it. And there I've just got the two left. You could reset it if you want to go back to the default. You could change the image. Now this is kind of cool too. I could go in, change the image. Let's say I add an icon for it instead. And we'll just pick one that comes up here, make it easy. And so then, now I would have to know, right? So I might want to mark that same one on my topic so that my brain could get those together as I go. You don't want to confuse yourself, but that would be something fun you could do as well. Let me undo that one. And then there are some other features. You can do different things. Like you can say, hey, I want to go through the section, but not return to the Zoom slide when I finish a section. You can turn off the little zoomy transition between them, but I kind of like that, so I'm going to leave it. And you can also set duration of how that works. Other things in there, you've got different kind of formatting pieces that you could utilize if you want to. Now I'm going to go back and show you from that insert. You could also, there's also a section zoom where you could pick just what you want and build it yourself. So I'm actually going to, I can delete those out of there and do a section zoom. And this makes it more manual. I'm going to insert these and you see what it did. It just, it layered them here, just stacked them. So you could be more purposeful about how you do it. And so when you run this show, and then you can pick as you go to it, it zooms in, you go through the topic information, and then you're zooming back out. So you could rearrange those a little bit. So just a different way to do it. I like having that kind of automated setup, but maybe you want to do something like this that makes more sense for your demonstration, whatever you're doing. There's another one I like, and I'm just going to go down and pick, maybe I'm on detail B, and I want to show this wow slide. I want to be able to jump to this one. Maybe it's going to be back to your budget summary or back to your big idea or whatever, something I want to return to. I'm actually going to just make a section here, add a section, call it wow, rename. I can actually come down here. This is where I wanted to put it. I can come and grab wow and drag it and drop it on another page. I'm dragging the section on there. So let's go back into running the show. I'm going to run the slideshow. When I get to my detail B, I'm going to see the little capture that takes me to another section. So you can embed this in and jump into another section from wherever you are in the show. So fancy it up a little bit. Try some of these summary Zooms. I know you've been hearing Zoom as in the program to run your virtual meetings, but you've also got this very cool summary Zoom feature in PowerPoint. So I hope you like it. Have a great one.